Hi, I'm Henrik. In this video, I'm going to talk about a new free toolkit that I've just released called Figment UDIM Globe, which will basically help you take any high-resolution planet texture and then split it into 32 smaller tiles. Also included are a bunch of 3D models that have appropriate UDIM UVs that you can then map the textures onto. In this first video, I'm going to show you how to install and use the ActionScript inside of Photoshop. And in the second video, I'm going to show you how to import the UDIM textures inside of 3ds Max using V-Ray. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop, and I already have a texture loaded. This is one of the NASA Invisible Earth textures, and it has a lot of pretty neat detail. All right, so the first thing we need to do is install the action scripts. So this is the entire UDIM Globe collection, and I'm just going to navigate to Photoshop Action folder up here, and then just drag this anywhere inside of Photoshop. And this is going to put a folder with all these scripts inside of the action tab. And if you don't have that open, you can just find it up here. So the first script up here will simply create guides. And this is useful for cases where you just tweaked a part of the texture. Maybe you painted in some detail in here and you just want to export just this one bit and not go through the whole process. Then you can use the top one. But for the full automation, where you just want to get everything out, you're going to use the second one down here. So let's just get rid of all these guides and just run the second one. This is going to take a while depending on the size and bit depth of the texture. So I'm just going to let this run and then speed it up in the edit. This might be a good time to mention that these action scripts should work on virtually any texture resolution that you would throw at them. But obviously your system needs to have enough memory to actually run them. So I would recommend for any textures of this size that your system has at least 32 gigs of memory. And it's done. So now everything has been split into these 32 layers. And if I disable the background, I can just drag these out and everything's been chopped up nicely. And all the layers have names that correspond to their UDIM coordinates. And these will be important when we export all of these layers. So let's navigate to File, Automate, and Batch. And in here, make sure that you select UDIM Globe Tools. And in the action tab here below, you have options to save as TIFF, EXR, and JPEG. So for any sort of data format, such as a displacement map or a black and white mask, I would always go for TIFF and EXR as these are lossless formats. But for something like this, that's a color map and it's an 8-bit, I think you can definitely get away with saving this as JPEG. And over here, you can pick the folder where you want to export all the files. Remember, you're going to get 32 of them in this folder. And in here, you can change the file name to whatever you want. Just make sure that you only change it in the top tab, because these down here, the extension, that's just going to automatically add TIFF, JPEG, whatever you choose. And this one will actually take the coordinate down here and then add it to the file name as a suffix, which is really important for loading the UDIM textures into your 3D software. And then finally, before I hit OK, it's important to note that the way that this batch works is any open files inside of Photoshop will be run through this. And this only really works if you've already run this script. So in short, I would recommend that you only do this on one texture at a time. And then finally, once everything has completed, it will close this document. So make sure that you've saved any information to the original texture and backed it up before doing any of this. All right, let's hit OK. And this is just going to run through and do its thing. So I'm just going to speed this up in the edit. And it's done. And this is our export folder. Just have a bunch of these tiles of the earth. Let's check that one out. Zoom in a bit. Looks pretty neat. All right, that concludes the first video. I hope you found this useful. And if you want to learn how to import and set these textures up using 3ds Max with V-Ray, then please watch the next video. That's it for me. Thanks for watching.